My name is Michael Ng. I'm a senior copywriter at Venables Bell and Partners, an advertising agency in San Francisco.
I'll be doing their man face.
We're shooting a commercial today for Stop AAPI Hate, a nonprofit organization that documents hate incidences targeted at Asian Americans and Pacific Islanders.
I'm an American-born Chinese. I'm third generation.
My parents were born in the U.S. and my grandparents emigrated from China. All my extended family is in San Francisco, and they've seen and felt the rise of Asian hate in the last few years. It's something we don't like to talk about, though, so this project means a lot to me.
My name's Amy McInnes, and I'm Malaysian Chinese.
Have you ever experienced a hate incident or verbal harassment or anything like that?
Yeah, I think to a point everyone here has, but we've always just shrugged it off.
Yeah, and we'll adjust the umbrellas a little bit.
Some people just aren't as understanding, and people are different. You have to kind of accept that.
I don't think I've been a victim of anything violent, but I've definitely faced a fair amount of discrimination verbally and harassment just growing up. I realized as I've gotten older and older that this is actually something that is pervasive and prevalent, and it's also something that you shouldn't really have to stand for.
Action. And cut.
Nope.
I think as of late, the AAPI community has a bigger spotlight shown on us, and I think it's actually really important that we seize this opportunity and we actually speak up.
Okay, I'm going for it, buddy. Close your eyes. Thank you, sir.
My name is Ernesto Cojuanco, and I am a Filipino. I hate to say this, but there's still racism, which it's not just here, but it's all over the world.
Yeah, let's plan an attack here. We'll get into a sort of a series.
Okay. All I can say is just like, let's try to understand and just show them love. Let's love them even if they hate us. Well, it can't go wrong.
All right, guys, we're going to try rehearsing again.
Let's march.
And action. And Sarah, you're ready walking. Cut. That was great.
I think that most Asian Americans and Pacific Islanders in general, I think we've always been told to be respectful, to be quiet. I think that we've been raised that way culturally and to just sort of blend in the background. And I think that it's actually really important for us to make ourselves known, to stand out and speak up.
If I could get 2 more inches on her height, like if we could raise her.
My name is Fei Ren, and I'm born and raised in China and migrated here 15 years ago. I know Zoey, our director. We actually, 2 years ago in pandemic, we were outside in around science world discussing some ideas on shorts or features. And then we encountered 5 people. They were at the beginning approaching me about my scooter, but then very quickly turning into a racial attack. And I remember both me and Zoey were going away, but then Zoey realized that they were approaching. And I was trying to find my phone in my backpack to record this. And I think maybe because it looked like I have a weapon in my bag or something, he suddenly got scared and ran away. When Zoey like approached me about this project, I would say, yeah, of course. It's important for those kind of project to be made just so that we can keep the conversation open. When I tell my friends my experience of racial attack, they always seem like really shocked, and they were like, why would that happen? I'm like, yeah, I also wonder why, but it does happen. I remember after first attack, I bleached my hair. I was trying to blend in and trying to stay small. I was afraid of being in my skin color. I think during that experience, what I realized is like my silence doesn't help. So it's really important to speak about it. It's really important to spread awareness and give each other support.